special presentation of the Unnecessary Ruffles Wrestling League. After a night of surprises, one man's return changed everything.
Seth Stern has returned, the Wrestler of the Year and the Rookie of the Year, squaring off for the first time since Asphyxiation 2007. And what could this possibly mean? Setting him up, Star David through the cell. My God!
Tag team circuit. And hopefully this tag team mini tournament can bring them a lot of success. Their opponents tonight, however, have a lot of bad blood running through their veins.
And their opponents from Muncie and Muskogee, Oklahoma, USA. They are the most successful tag team in the
history.
Hey, I want
to sing till Athena gets it right.
Please welcome,
let's harmonize,
Merle.
Be dynamite.
Well, you can find out by now, Merle Haggard Jr. needs to settle the score against Scorpion. Scorpion, as you all know, took out Merle Haggard Jr. in Episode 5 to advance himself in the URWL Hardkore Title Tournament, to enter himself illegally into the tournament and make it all the way to the finals before being defeated by Akina. Tonight, Merle Haggard Jr. has a chance to meet Scorpion one-on-one. Show Scorpion exactly what he feels. And momentarily, these two teams will kick off this new era of the URWL. The era of URWL wrestling. Look at that! German suplex! Taking the High Flyer champion down, and now Hog Wilker staring at Scorpion on the apron. Scorpion not amused, though, by that gesture. And now Hog, cradle pin. No, kick out by Cobra. Hog Wilker now. Double axe handle to the ropes. I'll take over. Let's go to the ropes. Slingshot vertical suplex. A very wise move there by Hog Wilker. And now back at the attack. Hog Wilker now. Triangle hold on the URWL High Flyer champion. But Cobra gets out. Cobra now. Clothesline. Recovering. Another clothesline. Cobra now back on the attack. Cobra. Great schoolboy. Looking for a pin now.
Two.
2-0. Another clothesline now. And a chop by Cobra. Over the bridge.
One,
look at this.
Two
and oh. Great attack set up here by both men. Going to tie up. Hog pushes Cobra away. Hog now. Another German suplex. Now Hog. Back on the attack again. Another triangle hold. The Cobra. Once again. Breaks loose. For another tie-up now. Hog pushes him away. Hog with the tie-up now. Wrist lock apply. Hog.
Rope break.
Sending down with an armbar, but no rope break called by the referee. Error in judgment there by Hog Wilker momentarily. Now Cobra back on the attack. Sends him loose. Hog reverses. Hog now. Great back suplex. Sends him right down. And now taking a moment to let the fans know that he's on the warpath. Hog now. Another wrist lock. Rolling him down an armbar.
Rope break.
But another rope break call. This Hog is in the wrong place at the wrong time here. Cobra's caught up in the ropes now, and Hog sends him down outside the ring. Big boot. And now Wilker continuing the attack outside the ring. Scorpion is there, though. And now a rear naked choke by Hog Wilker.
Two.
But does little to weaken Cobra. Scorpion coming up from behind.
Three.
Looking for an attack on Hog. Looking down to send him inside the ring.
Four.
Scorpion now on the apron. Series of chops right to the chest. Hog Wilker. Cobra looks to continue the attack inside the ring. Scorpion lets his grip go. Now, Cobra. Stand Hog up. First rush leg sweep into the mat. Cobra now. Bring up Wilker. Sending him to the corner. Cobra. From the top rope, look at this. Green Hurricane Rana. And now he's on the apron. Cobra now. To bring the top. Great springboard leg drop. And now the fans showing their distaste. Cobra now taunting Hog, signaling for him to get off the mat. And he finally does it himself. Cobra now, Irish whip to the ropes. Grabs Hog by the legs and sends him straight down on the canvas. That's a great show of strength there by the URWL High Flyer Champion as he tags his brother in. Scorpion now the legal man. And now, ScorpbrA on the attack, both of them. Vertical suplex on Hog Wilker. Scorpion wearing the rib tape now in this matchup, but I'm surprised that he's still able to move in this matchup. He was hurt pretty bad in that Hardkore Title Tournament Finals match at Digital Mayhem. And I don't think their solo careers really mean much at this stage. These two brothers are still helping each other out. Now Scorpion. Irish whip to the ropes. And a shoulder charge sends Hog Wilker down. Scorpion now. Back on the attack once again. Camel clutch. Hog looking to get out. And as you see the partners stepping into the ring, Cobra looking to take out Merle Haggard Jr., but Merle breaks up the submission. And now, Hog, look at this, running in. German suplex once again. Hog now. Irish whip to the corner. And here comes the tag. Merle going to the top rope, the legal man right now. Look at this. Doomsday device. What a move by Merle and Hog. And now the fans are going ballistic. They know Merle and Scorpion have a history. And now Merle on the attack. Series of punches and a double axe handle. And now Merle. Arm wrench. Elbow to the chest. Now look at this. Russian leg sweep. And the fans are loving this. Scorpion has no answer. Now air swimming Scorpion into his own corner. Series of attacks. Sending Cobra off the apron. Merle now. Leg whip takes Scorpion out. And now Merle. Looking for a submission here, Boston Crab. Near the ropes, though, and a rope break call. Merle now, Irish whip to the corner. Close on Scorpion. Merle now. Another Russian leg sweep. Great attack now by Merle Haggard Jr. on his rival Scorpion. Scorpion now reversing. Scorpion now, Russian leg sweep of his own. Scorpion, as you know, the man that took Merle Haggard Jr. out of the Hardcore Title Tournament in Episode 5. And now, finally, these two men can settle the score. Scorpion once again, a Russian leg sweep. And a great attack set out here by both men. Picking up Merle now. Scorpion looks to tie up. Get to the midsection. Headlock takeover. Scorpion. Gonna set him up. Jackhammer! Great attack set up by the former URWL champion. Scorpion out. Irish whip.
And he sends Merle Haggard Jr. outside the ring.
And it looks like the tables have turned because not too long ago, if you remember correctly, Ron Williker sent Cobra out of the ring with a big move. So the tables have definitely turned between these two teams.
Three.
And a combination of punches. Right into the barrier as Cobra was to get an attack in. And a drop kick sends Merle down. And right away, look at this. Hog Wilker, back suplex. As Cobra continues his assault on Merle Haggard Jr. Cobra now, Shining Wizard.
Seven.
Now the count is seven. Both legal and illegal men fighting one another.
Eight.
Count is at eight. Scorpion resets it. Scorpion now running in, picking up Merle, kick to the midsection. Scorpion now running back into the ring. As Cobra continues his onslaught on Merle Haggard Jr. Merle back on the attack against Cobra. And now, Scorpion, Irish Whip. This brawl has spilled out into the entrance way, ladies and gentlemen. Onto the ramp. Now Merle back on the attack against Scorpion.
Three.
Count is at four. Elbow to the chest once again. Russian leg sweep on the ramp.
Five.
One impact there by Merle Haggard Jr. Now Cobra running head scissors planting Merle Haggard Jr.'s head in the ramp. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back.
In times of need, where injustices are many, and heroes are few, one man stood up to the plate. One man vowed to make a difference. One man.
Seriously, would you shut the fuck up?
But I'm doing a commercial here. I have a script to read and everything.
I don't fucking care. My show, my commercial. Besides, do you know how fucking stupid you sound?
No, I don't. I sound normal, like everybody else. Anyway, what's so special about a crip with bad teeth and a face like a donkey's rear end?
It's ass, you fucking queer. Where did you learn to swear at a convent? Besides, you wouldn't say that if you were here. I'd run you down in my wheelchair and leave you for dead. Now let me break it down for these viewers.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'll shut up and be your biatch.
Okay, now before I start anything, I need to change. Ah, that's more like it. If you're looking for a show that makes the Block Killers look like the Asshole Appreciation Society, then this is the show for you. If you're looking for a show that makes YouTube Weekly look like a couple of cross-dressing queers, then this is the show for you. If you want a show that gives you the real deal straight up, untainted by political correctness, then this is the show for you. I am Stephen Hawking and I present the Halo-rama. Be down with us or our next victim, bitches.
For the ultimate uncensored video shoots, look no further than the Hatorama, only on URN.
Kiss my ass.
In 1994, it thrilled audiences with its intensity, and now, in 2008, this breathtaking motion picture experience can be seen by a new generation. For the first time on DVD, the Criterion Collection presents the Macedonian classic, Before the Rain. Now available from the Criterion Collection.
Excuse me. Where did you grow up?
Okay,
the woods?
Some things fall off my pizza, but that's only because it's got so much stuff on it, and I'm losing my balance.
I stole his cheese while he wasn't looking. Pizza raid. Use noise to disorient your opponent. That way you can get more of his stuff on your pizza.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back. Brawl has continued, but in more civilized form here inside the ring. As you see there, Hog Whitaker, legal man. And right away, Cobra now being tagged in. So the tables have turned. In this case, it's been a very back and forth kind of matchup. But it looks like ScorpbrA now has the advantage. Cobra now going to the top. Looking for something. It's a 450 splash. He hits it. Could be over right here, folks.
Two.
No. Hog Whitaker kicks out. And now you can just hear the advantage shifting in the favor of Merle and Hog. And a cradle pin. Hog Whitaker out. Two and no. Now Hog running in Schoolboy.
One.
Schoolboy pin.
Two
and no. Cobra looking to continue the attack. He misses. Hog Whitaker running in. Making up for it.
One.
Hog now. Two. No. Another kick out by Cobra. Cobra now. And a cradle pin by Cobra. Look
rope
at this.
Break.
Rope break call. Cobra taking the break to post to the fans. But it doesn't work. Shoulder charge by Hog Whitaker. Hog now. Formation of attacks to the axe handle. To the ropes. Cobra recovers. And a cradle pin.
Rope break
call. Hog now once again doing an onslaught. There's him from the corner. Hog now. Look at this. Necklock on the apron. Great creativity by Hog Whitaker there. As Hog sent back in the ring. Another shoulder charge. Sends Cobra down. Hog now posing. Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, the tag team mini tournament rules are as follows. The team that wins the match goes into the winner's bracket match on episode 8. However, the team that loses will have a second chance and advancing URWL Popular Demand 2008 has a secondary number one contendership, if you can call it that. And now, Hog! Swing Cobra up! You know what's coming, folks! Hog time! Here we go! The count is on! 2 and 3! Merle and Hog! Except for their first man, next to the longest CAW era! What an attack! Now, folks, the scene inside the ring says it all. Now the two brothers, Scorpion and Cobra, just staring each other down. No words being spoken. And Scorpion leaves the ring. I don't even want to know what the meaning of that was. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's main event may just be one of the biggest main events in URWL history. Barry White and Jaime Emo, the URWL Internet Champion and the URWL Champion, versus Interrogative and Seth Stern.
Every fan tells me the same thing. Seth, why'd you do it? Why'd you do it, huh? The only reason why I did it is because I had to do it. For those of you who forgot, Jaime Emo has made a career out of exploiting his lucky win in asphyxiation. He single-handedly used it as his ticket to the main event, using me as his personal stepping stone. Jaime, you know damn well I'm not a stepping stone. I'm the URWL's one true ambassador in the CAW world, the 2006-2007 Rookie of the Year, and I aim to make your first championship reign an embarrassment. There's a reason, Jaime Emo, why I don't call myself the Deuce anymore. It's because I, Seth Stern, am truly number one. Don't you fucking forget it.
Harsh words, folks, would be an understatement. Seth Stern undoubtedly wants that opportunity to go one-on-one with Jaime Emo at Popular Demand. But enough of that. New fan favorite Trent Tail is in action. Let's go to Annie Mace in terms of this contest. Folks, as you saw Digital Mayhem, Trent Tail at one point in that contest had the fans against him. But it only took a few reversals of fortune to make Trent Taylor, a true fan favorite here in the URWL. It was career reinvention at Digital Mayhem, but tonight, Trent Taylor has the opportunity to continue his successful comeback against Victor Cordaro. Well, of course, Victor Cordaro is now one of the URWL's most controversial figures. He is the alleged mastermind of the so-called Kansas City Screwjob. Torres was one step away from winning the URWL High Flyer title against Cobra when, after he hit the aerial impaler, Victor Cordaro jumped the barrier disguised as a URWL fan and managed to take out Torres without a hint of response. Cobra or the URWL official assigned to the contest. Because of these circumstances, an investigation has been launched by myself and the URWL Board of Directors. Because of this investigation, we have not booked Torres in this event. And if Torres decides to show up in the URWL Arena tonight, we have one of two options to consider. One, suspending him indefinitely, or two, utilizing one of many contingency plans that the staff has in place. And if Torres merely steps out of the entrance door, we have full executive privilege to make sure that he is met with the required disciplinary action. With all that aside, folks, this contest looks to be a great exhibition. High-flying skill that these two men possess. And I'm very excited to be presenting it to you tonight here on Episode 7 of URWL Wrestling. Now both men looking to execute in reverse. Showing off the technical skill. Cordaro now. Arm drag. Cordaro now. Victory roll. Look at this. Right near the ropes, though. Count is still on. Two and no. Tail kicks out. Victor Cordaro sporting a brand new image and a brand new attitude. He does not care what these URWL fans think of it. Cordaro now. Going up to the top. Look at this. Split legged moonsault. Great attack. Cordaro. One, two, and no. And it's been very fast-paced action so far here in this matchup between Trent Taylor and Victor Cordaro. It's now Taylor. School wide pin. Two. And no. Kick out. Cordaro now looking more like a street thug than a legitimate Lucha Libre wrestler. I guess that's just his new persona here. He doesn't care what the fans think of him. And now, another schoolboy. Two. And no. Trent Taylor, great pin attempt there. But it was not to be. Taylor now from behind. Excellent heads are just take down. Into a pin attempt. Look at this. 2-0. And some very fast-paced action tonight. Very agile action from these two high flyers. And with a bridge. Puts the ropes from the count still on. 2-0. Multiple pins attempted by both men here. Cordaro looking for an attack. Cradle pin. Cordaro now. Looking for a pin of his own. 2-0. Arm drag now by Tail. Setting Victor down. Tail now. Stop to the chest. Tail. One more ropes and this. Springboard elbow. Excellent agility by Tail. And now Tail with a springboard moonsault of his own. Going for the pin. One, two, and no. Kick out again by Cordaro. Tail running in. Acrobat clothesline. Barely hits. Cordaro reeling. Time coming. Cordaro now. Public case is going to break it up. But Tail. Float over. Neckbreaker here, and he gets it. Trent Taylor sporting some new attire tonight, kind of coinciding with his new appreciation by the fans. Taylor now with the back toss. Sending Cordaro to the canvas. Taylor now bouncing off the ropes. Look at that. Great elbow drop. Great execution there. Great agility by Trent Taylor. Now Taylor. Headlock takeover. Cordaro trying to go free, but no. Great DDT by Trent. Tail now mocking Cordaro, saying no mas. Well, if I were Cordaro, I'd come back roaring after something like that. And he does. Headlock takeover versus the tie-up. Now Cordaro headlock takeover once again. Cordaro now. Leg whip right down the canvas. Cordaro. What agility. Handspring splash. Great attempt by Victor. And now, Victor in the ropes once again. Springboard moonsault. Over the cover. 2-0. Cordaro, back on the attack. Spinning around. Look at this, Hurricanrana. And the pin on him again.
Two
and no. Trent Taylor kicks out. Excellent match by both men tonight. Really showing off their poise. Really showing off their skill. Really showing that both their styles mesh well together inside the ring. As Cordaro, vertical suplex, slowing this match down a bit. It's been fast-paced action from the starting bell here. URWL Wrestling Episode 7. Cordaro now. Looking for something to happen. Look at this. Running head scissors. Victor now. Bringing up Trent. There's the corner. Cordaro now. Close line in the corner. Cordaro going to the top. Victor now. Look at this. Hurricane right up on the top. Dios mio indeed. But the fans are liking that too much. There's no doubt in my mind that Victor Cordaro is a talented competitor, but what he might have done in Digital Mayhem, we're not sure yet. It was a despicable act. Off the ropes, look at this. Springboard to a back elbow. Cordaro. Springboard moonsault once again.
One.
A cover, two, and no. Tail kicks out. Both of these guys come from north and south of the border of the United States, and both have shown us in their URWL careers that they definitely have the talent to be good title contenders here in the URWL, but will that happen in the future? Tail now. Hurricanrana and a series of punches. Defense crescendo as Tail back in the attack. Sending Cordaro up. Irish whip to the apron. Cordaro gets back in the ring. Cordaro now. Taking Tail's legs out. Underneath him. Taking Tail up. Sending him out of the apron. And down.
One.
Now Cordaro, look at this! Dios mio! Springboard moonsault to the outside! That is why, folks, he's a multiple-time Mexican Lucha Libre champion.
Three.
No matter what he thinks of the fans. And now Cordaro,
four.
Going to the top inside the ring, look at this! Spilling a moonsault!
One.
A reverse split-legged moonsault of sorts to see the master control. What a move by Cordaro.
Three.
Unfortunately, he couldn't get the pin outside the ring, but it just goes to show how big of a talent Victor Cordaro is. Now Cordaro continuing the assault. Punches now to the barrier.
Six.
Now an Irish whip. Going to send Tail inside the ring. Sends him staggering. Count is at seven. Cordaro. Send him back in.
Eight.
Unsuccessful so far. Steps getting in the way. Cordaro now. Running it himself.
Nine.
Count is at nine. Tail gets back in. Tail now on the attack. Tying up. Cordaro looking to get out. But Tail, look at this. Roll over once again. Into a neck breaker. And now this match has gone back and forth and back and forth so many times. We are completely unsure if we will see a winner tonight. Tail now. Backing up. Super kick. Right to Cordaro. And now, obviously in pain, favoring his ribs. Moving away. Tail now looking to tie up once again. Tail. That's just drew a pin once again.
One,
Tail now looking for the win. Two and no. Can't get it done. Acrobatic clothesline barely hits once again. But Cordaro. Great arm drag. Cordaro now. First takedown, sending Tail down. Once again, excellent handspring splash. Cordaro now once again. Springboard moonsault.
One.
Looking for the win.
Two
and oh. Victor Cordaro coming so close to a victory. Sends him down with a dropkick. Cordaro jumping on the second rope. We see this one in Digital Mayhem, folks. Straight edge for the takedown. But look who's come back to settle the score. Cordaro completely oblivious here to who's behind him. The fans going crazy. Cordaro thinks for him, but it's for Torres. I told him not to intervene, but he just couldn't be stopped, huh? He just couldn't be stopped. Torres now. Irish to the corner. Aerial Impaler.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has notified me that this match will end in a draw due to interference.
This matter will be dealt with. Torres was not supposed to come to the arena tonight, and now he will face the consequences. Unprofessional behavior, folks.
Rated E for everyone.
A real jerk.
Well, I am a corporate executive.
He stops exciting things from happening.
So what you doing?
Well, Muffy, Buffy, Biff Jr. and I are going on our Sunday drive.
Oh, no, you ain't. You're gonna play pole position!
This is an advertisement. This is a very bad advertisement. This could be your advertisement. Stop by the URWL rant board in the commercial request thread, and this will be your advertisement.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you just saw, Taurus taking matters into his own hands. As I said before, this matter will be dealt with, and Taurus will either face suspension or one of many contingency plans that the URWL staff has written up. But enough of that, folks. This matchup coming up will determine the number one contender of the URWL North American Championship. Let's take it over to Andy Mace to introduce Aleksandar Kuleshov.
URWL North American Championship. Introducing first, from Kazan, Russia, weighing in at an even 200 pounds, he is Aleksandar, AK-47.
While Kuleshov is becoming one of the URWL's more controversial talents, the fans resent him. The internet wrestling community despises him. But if Kuleshov wins tonight, will the commander be number one on his list of adversaries? That remains to be seen, folks. And now we await the entrance of the former URWL champion and recently the former URWL internet champion, Salvatore.
Now the second contender in this match. The Isle of Sicily, weighing in at 252 pounds, Salvatore!
I would say, folks, that Salvatore got one of the biggest surprises of the night at URWL Digital Mayhem 2008. He was preparing to face Jaime Emo in the first match of the evening. However, Jaime Emo, in one of the more controversial moves of the evening, gave Salvatore the middle finger, stepped outside the ring, and brought back Salvatore's biggest adversary, the 18-time URWL champion, Barry White. While I agree with a lot of the fans that have been saying that Salvatore did not deserve his URWL Internet Championship, and in this case, Salvatore needs to prove to all of us that he can earn a shot at the URWL North American Championship. Tonight can earn a second chance at the URWL North American Championship. You will be able to face the commander man that beat him one-on-one at the very end of the Blood Invitational four-way dance match at URWL Digital Mayhem 2008. If he wins this contest tonight, he and the commander will square off toe-to-toe any type of match stipulation voted for by URWL fans. It could be any type of match. If Blood succeeds tonight, expect the unexpected. Blood never cared for the URWL rulebook. He never cared for the URWL fans, but he went on the winning streak of his career when he held that URWL North American Championship. It was just recently at Digital Mayhem that the commander took it away from him. And ladies and gentlemen, here comes our fourth competitor. A man that has seen better days. But will those better days come back to him tonight? We will see. Here comes Fusion. Fusion has the distinction of being the only British-born wrestler here on the URWL roster. He has always been a fan favorite. And the fans are waiting for that one match that brings Fusion over the top here in the URWL. That makes him a serious title contender. And this match may just be it. Fans rally behind him. They know his potential. They know how skilled he is, how talented he is. They're just waiting for that golden moment, that golden opportunity. And they're waiting for Fusion to capture that opportunity, that moment. It could just be tonight, folks. Fusion is a very well-rounded competitor, a very balanced competitor. He does not gravitate to one side of the spectrum. He is a high flyer, a technician, a powerhouse, a submission wrestler. He just may be the prototypical URWL wrestler. Keep your eye on him. He's a special competitor. Now the match is underway. Fusion now, running in, taking Blood down the shoulder charge. Now Aleksandar Kuleshov, sidekick sends Salvatore down. Blood and Fusion have not met, as I said, since episode 3 in a one-on-one situation. If you haven't forgot, folks, they met in the four-way dance at Digital Mayhem, what happened to be the last match of the Blood Invitational. And wouldn't it be something to see Blood and Fusion go head-to-head in the future? These two men don't like each other. Fusion now. Sending Kuleshov off the ropes. Lightning now sends him down. Salvatore. With Blood, looking for an Oklahoma Slam as Fusion now. Reverse sharpshooter. Blood now reversing out of that Oklahoma Slam with a reverse DDT. Now Fusion back on the attack. Fusion looking to go after Blood, but he ends up taking Kuleshov down. Leg up to the canvas. Blood now with a bow and arrow on Salvatore. Fusion now. Fires up to the corner. We're going to work over Kuleshov now. In the corner. Off the turnbuckle. Look what's going to happen here. Back body drop. Off the top rope. That's what makes Fusion so unpredictable as a competitor here. He's just so well-versed as he takes Salvatore down with the snapmare. And look at this. Fusion out. The only man left standing. Pumping up the crowd. And they love him here at the URWL Arena. That's for sure. Salvatore now sending Fusion down with a throat thrust. Kuleshov running in. Kick right to Fusion's chest. Kuleshov now. Big combination sending Fusion down. Blood off the ropes. Great neck breaker. Blood and Kuleshov now. Kuleshov sweeps Blood's legs out from underneath it. And now Kuleshov looking for the pin on Salvatore. Count is at two and no. Salvatore kicks out. Kuleshov and Blood going after one another. Blood now looking for an opening. Sending Kuleshov onto the top rope. Crotch first as Salvatore Oklahoma slam into the canvas on Fusion. But Fusion reverses. Fusion now back on the attack. Irish whip. Takeover. Right into an arm wrench. The great sidekick on the run. Now Salvatore. Looking for something here. Fusion looking to reverse. First DDT. Now Blood. Sending Kuleshov to the corner. Series of chops upcoming. Fusion now. Look at this. Great back suplex. Fusion. Looking up Salvatore. For attack here. Look at this. Fusion. He's got him up. Fusion focus. Great move on Salvatore! And now Fusion goes for the pin! One, two, and... Now Fusion breaks up the pin. He wants to go after Salvatore some more. He doesn't think he's weakened enough. and a discus punch sends Salvatore outside the ring, and now a running neckbreaker by Fusion on Blood. Fusion has really taken care of this matchup so far. Now Kuleshov backing up, kick to Blood. Now Fusion running in from behind. Look at this, Fusion move to the pit, two and no. Kuleshov kicks out. Great schoolboy there. Now Kuleshov sends Blood down the sweep. Kuleshov backing up for Blood now. Kick to Blood's midsection now. Kuleshov now. Look at this. Rear naked choke. Confusion tap out here and no. Kuleshov breaks the hold. And now Kuleshov on the ropes. Shining Wizard. Great agility there by Aleksandar Kuleshov. MMA crossover from Russia. Now Blood and Salvatore back up. Taking each other on. Kuleshov now in the corner. So straight into the turnbuckle. Kuleshov now. Irish whip. The opposing turnbuckle. And look at that. Shining Wizard in the corner. Now Kuleshov on the run. Face wash on Fusion. Kuleshov has turned the table so far. Now Kuleshov going after Salvatore, former internet champion. Kuleshov sends Salv down to the sweep. And a running sidekick on Blood. And look at this now, folks. Kuleshov, the only man standing, going after Blood. Series of kicks once again. And a running sidekick sends Blood down. Ring leg drop there, barely hits. Kuleshov now going back after Salvatore. Fusion still down on the mat. Kuleshov now. This, folks, it's Kuleshov rush. Kuleshov rush on Salvatore. And now a triangle hold on Salvatore. Look at this. And now Blood looking to lock it in. Boston Crab on Fusion. Two submissions at once here. Kuleshov could be ending the match here. Triangle hold as Blood exerting his force on Fusion with the Boston Crab. But Fusion spins right out of it. Kuleshov still locking to Salvatore into the triangle hold, and Fusion breaks it up. And now Fusion going after Kuleshov. Irish whip to the corner, Kuleshov falls down. Referee gets in the way of Fusion though. Fusion now trying it again. Successful. Fusion now with an elbow. Sending Kuleshov into the turnbuckles. And finally sends Kuleshov down. Fusion now. Irish whip once again. And now Fusion. We're gonna grapple against the ropes. And he slides Kuleshov out of the ring. Great attack there by Fusion. And Kuleshov's out. Running DDT now on Salvatore. And Salvatore's busted open. The fans now cheering on Fusion as he poses to all of them. Fusion now. Picking up Salvatore. Irish whip in the corner. Fusion. Now with the back elbow. Looking for something to happen. Salvatore doesn't let anything happen. The last hand by Blood. And now both men going after Fusion. Salvatore sends Fusion down. And now Aleksandar Kuleshov back into the ring. Look at this! Great sidekick by Kuleshov. Ring leg drop on Fusion barely hits. Salvatore now going after Fusion. Pete stops with the head. For a time now, Salvatore reverses it. And Blood.
One.
Looking for a pin on Fusion now. Two. Fusion kicks out. He's not dead yet, folks. But Salvatore back in the attack. Choking the life out of the man from the United Kingdom. Now Salvatore. Reverse back break around Blood. Salvatore is now the only man standing. And Kuleshov gets right back up to his feet. Kuleshov now. Going after Fusion. Going after Salvatore. Kuleshov now. Look at that. Reverse sidekick on Fusion. Now a sweep sends Fusion's legs out from underneath him. And now Kuleshov, look at this! It's the rush! Kuleshov rush! And now going after Blood, triangle hold! It could be over right now! And Blood taps out!
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner and new.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Cold War may have ended, but Aleksandar Kuleshov just may have reignited the Cold War with his win tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, the URWL is coming to a city near you. Let's check with the URWL City Report to see just where the URWL may be headed next.
The action, the intensity, the emotion. Nothing matches the experience of seeing the URWL live. This Friday, the URWL invades Montreal. Next Wednesday, the URWL rolls into Harrisburg. Billings, Montana hosts the URWL next Saturday. And coming soon, tickets will be on sale for URWL Popular Demand 2008 in Los Angeles, California. Feel the intensity of the URWL in a city near you. And ladies and gentlemen, now one of these two tag teams will be able to win the opportunity to participate at URWL Popular Demand 2008 if they advance in the URWL Tag Team Tournament.
Ladies and gentlemen,
this first tag team tonight,
second match
to Gordon Norman and
URWL Tag Team
Instructions.
Introducing the first team from Sydney, Australia, and from Oregon, they are Carlo and JJ Brown. They are the experts of execution. They are E.O.E.
Carlo and JJ Brown are true veterans here in the URWL. They have seen many tag teams come and go. However, Great White North just may be one of the more dynamic tag teams out there. As you know, in episode 5, when they made their debut, they defeated EOE for a chance to advance to URWL Digital Mayhem 2008. Since that day, EOE has been very bitter. Carl Lode tells me that they will stop at nothing until they humiliate the Great White North and win a chance at the URWL Tag Team titles.
Okay. Good day, welcome to Great White North.
And listen to this crowd as they cheer on these two men from Toronto. Great White North.
Ryan Stafford. Sean McKendrick. They are the Great White North.
They came up short at Digital Mayhem, folks. But not without a fight. The Great White North are still one of the most electric tag teams in URWL history, regardless of the fact that they lost. Ladies and gentlemen, wouldn't it be nice if both of these men can reclaim their rightful URWL Tag Team Title No. 1 contenderships and eventually URWL Tag Team Mini Tournament in Episode 8. We'll see. And as you hear now, the GWN chants. And right off the bat, Sean McKenzie sends low down, right through Carl's legs, running in and running snapmare. Great start by Sean McAndrew. Picking up load now. Irish whip to the corner. McAndrew now. Sending load down. Three more body splash. Look at that, folks. Going for the pin now early.
Two
and no. Load kicks out. Sean now looking to get back on the attack. Bring that trigger on load. Sean now. Over the apron. Three more late drop. Now. McAndrew. Going to the opposite rope. Look at this now. Somersault leg drop. That's what I'm talking about when I say the Great White North are one of the most electric and electrifying tag teams in the URWL today, and maybe in the URWL's history. Commander running in. Great neck breaker. Right from the top rope. And now Sean. Arsenal in the corner. Here comes Kyle Stafford. And now the Great White North adding to their arsenal of double team moves. Listen, Carl Lode on the top rope. For a run. Oh, and they sleepfrog. That sends Carl Lode down. Staggering to the canvas. Now Stafford. Back suplex on Carl Lode. Stafford now with this. Sent out from the apron. Now Kyle. Closing. What a agility by Stafford. Break dancing late drop. You never know what to expect from these two men. And a back toss now by Kyle Stafford. Sends Carl Lode down. And the fans are loving it, folks. Stafford now. Archie to the corner. Sends Lode right into it. And out. Stafford. German suplex. Right to the center of the ring. Working over Lode. Picking him up. Sending him right to the corner again. The Great White North. Another Great White North. Look at that. Shades of the Eliminators. That's what they called total elimination back in the day. I wonder what the Great White North calls it. We'll just have to look that up, folks. We'll have to ask them after the show. That was an outstanding maneuver. And now, Sean McAndrew on the ropes. Great elbow drop. Sean McAndrew is so agile. And now, this is himself to Carl Lode on the mat. Lode, into the landslide. Spear! Could it be over right now, folks? Sean McAndrew! Pose and send Carl Lode back up. It's not over yet.
crusher. Right in the apron. J.J. Brown, as you see, has not been tagged in yet. Carl Lode has had to face this attack on his lonesome. And a running neckbreaker by Carl Lode. Carl Lode finally in this matchup. And E.O.E. finally has a presence. Now Lode. Look at this now. The powerhouse, Carl Lode. First powerbomb. Sending him straight backwards instead of sending him down. Now Carl Lode. Picking up McAndrew. Headlock tickle. Lode. Scoop and slam. Carl Lode obviously needs to make a tag, but he hasn't gone anywhere near his corner. Lode now. He'll drop the elbow, and he does. And Lode, exerting his will. Push-ups on the mat. Yeah, we all know you're strong, Carl. Just prove it in the ring this time. Lode now running in. Spear in the corner. Sean McAndrew staggering. And out. Carl Lode. McAndrew to the EOE corner. Now tagging J.J. Brown. Look at this now. There's whip. And J.J. sends him down with a flying clothesline. And finally, the former bouncer for Portland, Oregon, J.J. Brown. Front dropkick by Brown. J.J., as you know, he was in solo competition a few weeks back, competing against Blood in one of the final matches of the Blood Invitational. We know J.J. is a really powerful combatant. Yeah. But we haven't seen that much of him in this contest. Heck, we haven't even seen him at all. See there an Australian flag. We have a lot of, actually, Australian fans in the URWL arena tonight, making a trip to see Carl Lode. Now, J.J. This Shining Wizard! J.J. Brown almost taking a page out of the Great White North's playbook there. I don't know where that came from. J.J. now, Irish to the corner. Looking for something to happen here. On the top, over that! Arm drag from the top! Great attack now by J.J. Brown. Sean McAndrew desperately needs to make a tag. But just as I said that, folks, E.O.E. make the tag. How ironic. And now, double leg lock on Sean McAndrew. The fans know Sean needs to make a tag to Kyle Stafford immediately. Now Carl Lode, after a rest on the apron, finally back in action. Carl Lode now. Pick up McAndrew. Look at this! Jackhammer! Right in the middle of the ring! McAndrew reeling! If anything, the Great White North cannot really counter these powerful attacks. They can only counter them with speed and agility. And Sean McAndrew just may do it! Cross the pin! Looking for the win now! Referee down the count! Two! J.J. Brown breaks it up! We could have had winners there, folks! Sean McAndrew was on the mat, had everyone in the arena fooled, and now the Great White North emerged with the advantage. Lode takes it down, Sean spins out, front dropkick, right to the board of Carl Lode. Now Sean moving the bridge,
two.
But J.J. breaks it up after a two count. Now, McAndrew, it goes for good once again here.
One.
McAndrew now,
two.
One leg, two, J.J. breaks it up once again. Now Carl Lode picks him up, an electric chair. Man, that's got to take a lot out of Sean McAndrew there. And E.O.E. make the tag once again. Look for another double team maneuver. There's once again to the ropes. And another aerial clothesline by J.J. Brown. As J.J. continues the attack. Tying up with Sean McAndrew now. J.J. going to start something. Into the punch and a throat thrust by Brown. Brown now, taking McAndrew down. Series of punches off the Fez press. Now J.J. Here's one to the corner. Something happened. J.J. Brown now. Necklock on the ropes. We've seen this earlier, I think, from Hog Whitaker. J.J. continuing that creativity that Whitaker exhibited earlier. Sean McAndrew now. Look at this. Sean fighting back in the corner now. Sean setting J.J. up. Look at this now. Neckbreaker from the top rope. Sean needs to make a tag. Instead, he sends up J.J. Brown. Irish whip to the corner now. And here they go. Kyle Stafford's illegal man. Oh, and a great leg drop. The fans have erupted. And now Kyle Once again, breakdance and leg drop. Great creativity by Kyle Stafford. Knee drop to JJ. Stafford now. Looking for an opening. Can't get it. JJ Brown now. Big boot sends Kyle Stafford down. And now, Irish whip. And you're looking for something. Back toss. Right down the canvas. And now, E.O.E. setting up another attack. Same move in reverse. Carlo now on the attack. Kyle Stafford. Back body drop here. He gets it. Great strength by Kyle Stafford. Exhibited throughout this match. Kyle now. Irish whip. Barely hits an acrobat. Clothesline. And now Carlo running in. Great German suplex. Stafford has no response. And now Carl Lode in the middle of the ring. Campbell clutch. But he breaks the hold. Stafford now looking for an opening. This cradle pin. Bring it ropes though. Comes to on 2-0. Stafford now. Chop sitting low down. Puts him back up. Time coming. Carl Lode. Looking to get out. He does. Lode running in. Another German suplex. Right to Kyle Stafford. Stafford has no answer. Irish whip now. Right to the corner. Tagging in JJ. Powerbomb position. And now JJ. Springboard coming. Look at that. Sends him right down. Kyle Stafford may be out cold here. The count is on. Two and three. E.O.E.
Ladies and gentlemen, the openers
have pulled off the upset. And an event, their episode 5 loss to the Great White North. E.O.E. will now be Berlin Hawk in the winner's bracket in episode 8. Ladies and gentlemen, we have our cameras in the locker room now, and it seems that, yes, Victor Cordaro has a message for Taurus. And let's see what he says, folks. Let's go back there right now.
Toro. Pinche cabrón, no tuviste el motivo, hijo de puta! They told you to leave me alone! Now who's the one who screwed, huh? The staff told you to give away from me, and by doing what you did, ese, you're gonna be suspended! So I'm popular demand, if you really want to get revenge, start counting how many fans you have, cabrón, or else su trasero es chingado, pinche pendejo!
Well, some harsh words there by Victor Cordaro to the former number one contender for the URWL High Flyer title, Taurus. And as I said before, folks, the situation with Taurus will be addressed in the future. But right now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for action in the URWL Women's Division. Cecilia Rincón will face the woman that is coming out of the entrance right now. She is Kelsey MacDonald.
Introducing first, from Portland, Oregon, Ontario. Hanging at 159 pounds, Kelsey.
It's safe to say, fans, that Kelsey was on top of the world after episode 6. She took out nearly every single member of the URWL Women's Division to win the number one contendership at the URWL Women's Championship. However, her match at Digital Mayhem was far from constructive. It was an embarrassment, and she needs to show every single one of her URWL fans that she is still here to win. However, it won't be easy. The woman she's facing tonight, Cecilia Rincón, has been looking dominant as of late. Thought of as a possible number one contender for Jesse Slash's URWL Women's Championship. After a win at Digital Mayhem, the wheels started turning in the minds of the fans and in the minds of the internet wrestling community at large. It was Theme Anthology that coined the term Rincón. Well, that's exactly what she did to the recently departed Kali Nakamura at Digital Mayhem 2008. However, Rincón still has a lot to show us. And no, I'm not talking about skin. I'm talking about wrestling ability, and I'm talking about the ability to translate that ability into wins, if that makes any sense. Now we're underway. Now MacDonald, we're in the attack, rear naked choke. Near the ropes, though.
Rope break.
And just as I thought, rope break is called. Kelsey MacDonald needs to pick up the pieces. Jan, an embarrassing loss to Digital Mayhem. Look at this. Handspring dropkick sends Rincón out of the ring.
One.
And MacDonald going to the top. Look at this. Splash to the outside.
One.
Great attack by Kelsey.
Two.
Close to the fans. But not for long. Rincón. Club right to the back.
Three.
As I was trying to say earlier, Kelsey needs to pick up the pieces from her embarrassing loss in the hands of Jesse Slash. If she wants to prove to the fans that she belongs here in the URWL Women's Division, she needs to show them
six.
That she is here to play with a win against Cecilia Rincón here tonight.
Seven.
Like I said, it's the first time these two met one-on-one.
Eight.
Cecilia now counts at eight. Kept to whip her into the ring.
Nine.
Now at nine, MacDonald resets the count, and she's met instantly by Cecilia Rincón. Series of punches after the spear.
Two.
And a big boot sends Kelsey down. And undoubtedly, Cecilia Rincón looks to have the advantage right now. Picks her up by the hair and sends her down. Counts at four. Rincón hurts into the ring. And she steps in right after her. Rincón now looking for the tie up. MacDonald reverses. Kelsey now. Putting it. Necklock suplex. Sends her right down. Now a jumping fist drop on the canvas. Kelsey
rope
now.
Break.
A pin, rope break call. Pulling back slide
rope
now.
Break.
Rope break call once again. Rincón now on the attack. First whip. Rincón now. Look at this. Belly to belly suplex. Great attack by Cecilia. Showing her power off. Now going for the pin.
One.
Rincón.
Two.
Going for the pin early. Two and no. Kelsey MacDonald kicks out. What a great impact there after the belly-to-belly suplex by Cecilia. First one to the corner. Cecilia now. Lean out of the face. Take over running, and yes, pulled off. Now Cecilia distancing herself. She made an impact, as you all know, at Digital Mayhem, but can't she make it against the rest of the women's division? But can't she make an impact long-term? We will see. Look at this. Another neck lock suplex. Now blowing a kiss to the crowd. Coming in and rolling clothesline. Kelsey now. Good opportunity. Kelsey. Looking for something here. The sharpshooter. Chains of her hero, Bret Hart. And she breaks the hold. Kelsey now. On takeover. Cecilia looking to get out. More punches. Something. Belly to belly. Cecilia exhibited that move earlier. Kelsey says, anything you can do, I can do better. Similar to the mentality of her match against Jesse Slash and Mayhem. And sends her down in the corner with the head scissors. And now Kelsey going up to the top rope. Look at this. Kelsey McDonald, moonsault. From the top rope, look at that. Over the pin, 2-0. Cecilia kicks out. Just like I said in the Great White North EOE matchup, even though Kelsey doesn't have that strength advantage, she can still dominate with speed, agility, and her technical ability. Now Kelsey, in the middle of the ring, figure four leg lock, looking for something to happen here. Rincón trying to escape. Can she do it? Yes, she does, moving her foot away. And she spins out. Cecilia now looking for a knee lift, misses. Punch in the back of Kelsey. And now, shot by Rincón sends Kelsey down. Now Rincón on the mat. Airplane spin. Great attack set up by Rincón now. And Rincón. Kelsey's heading into the turnbuckle pad. Going to the top now. Rincón! Great double axe handle from the top rope. Cecilia Rincón proving that she's not one-dimensional. and out after the Irish whip. Belly to belly once again. Now Rincón picking Kelsey back up. I want to take over. Rincón now. Jordan Closeline. Kelsey back up. And another. One power by Rincón. Rincón running in. And a big boot sends Kelsey down. Closing momentarily. Going back on the attack. Cecilia now, leg drop hits. Cecilia, picking up a Kelsey by the hair and slams her down. Once again, like we saw outside the ring. Cecilia now looking for something. Kelsey reverses. Kelsey now back on the attack. Snapmare takedown. And Kelsey now, signaling the fence, something's coming up. Great cartwheel elbow drop. Great offense by Kelsey. And now Kelsey once again. Sharpshooter coming. Shades of the Hitman, but no. The hold is broken. Irish whip now. Kelsey. Belly to belly. Once again. And now. Posing to the fans. Looking for something big here. Kelsey. Hoist Cecilia up. Girl killer! She hits it! It's over, folks! Kelsey taking one more opportunity to taunt Cecilia when she's down. And now walking in, looking for that pin. Cecilia falls to the mat, and she makes the cover. Hooking the leg, two. Cecilia kicks out! Throws her right off! And look at this! Cecilia Rincón back on the attack. She kicked out the schoolgirl killer. Rincón with a second win. And look at this now. Sending Kelsey up. Kelsey MacDonald just got Rincón. What a power bounce for the cover. Two and three. Cecilia Rincón pulls the win out of absolutely nowhere. If I were Jesse Slash, I would be shaking in my boots right now. What a dominant professional. This will no doubt improve Cecilia's chances to be voted in as the number one contender at Popular Demand. Folks, let's take a look. Kelsey MacDonald had her almost down for the count with the schoolgirl killer. She had her at two, and then Cecilia Rincón with a powerful second win throws her right off. And yes, Kelsey MacDonald gets Rincón. And ladies and gentlemen, as you know, Barry White and Jaime Emo will collide with Interrogative and Seth Stern. Coming up next, though, ladies and gentlemen, is the URWL Explosion of the Evening. This freestyle hardcore match, folks, will not be for the faint of heart.
And now, Akina, he just won the table on fire, folks! Please don't know!
Scorpion now, what's gonna happen here?
No!
This is not the match right now.
It was a career-defining night, that's for sure. And for this man, Akina, will his winning streak continue? In episode 7, our fortune was on the line.
Talking about Akina, you're talking about a very focused, very intense, and a very, very powerful competitor. His first belt here in the URWL is the URWL Hardcore title. Not a bad place to start, especially after the results of a match that fans are already calling the URWL match of the year. Akina proved that he is for real, that he should deserve a spot here in the URWL.
Why are you torturing me like this?
Why?
Carnage.
And he wanted to close me, and you stood there like a fuck, and you watched him burn me down.
The Downfall Syndicate.
From Montreal, Quebec, weighing at 275 pounds, he is one half of the URWL Tag Team Champions, the Downfall Syndicate. He is Adrien.
As you see, there are still problems with our signal, and we will try to get them fixed as soon as possible. And we're off. Adrien Carnage now. Look at this. Allows no time for Akina to start the match off with his trademark sidekick, and he's on the attack right away. Adrien now. I'm on takeover. And a great DDT. Adrien Carnage is just so ruthless. The URWL Hardcore title was made for someone like him. And I think what makes Adrien so despicable as a wrestler is his willingness to go above and beyond the call of duty and not in the way we intend. We're talking about bending the rules, assaulting referees, doing things that'll get him suspended, just like when he bit Shady Perkins way back in episode 2, which was one of the causes, sadly, of the formation of the Downfall Syndicate. Well, I guess you live and learn. Ladies and gentlemen, URWL Hardcore Rules, as I point out, does not allow any managers or any tag team partners at ringside. URWL wrestlers cannot be accompanied by anyone else. So I guess in this case, Adrien Carnage is feeling a little light on support at ringside. Great suplex by Akina. And now, raising his arms up to the crowd. They responded with a crescendo. And a chance start once again. Akina now. Does he see himself? Shining Wizard. And now Akina. Once again. Running kick to the chest. Akina now. Sending Adrien up. Irishman for the ropes. Running sidekick barely hits. Akina back on the attack now. Arm drag sends him down. And once again, posing to the fans. In love what Akina brings to the table. Akina, Digital Mayhem, has an outlast Scorpion, former URWL Hardcore Champion, the winningest Hardcore Champion, I must say, in URWL's history. It's Adrien now, winning the ET. So saying, Akina did a lot in that matchup to prove to all of us that he really belongs here in the URWL. It's Adrien Carnage, using the ladder against Akina. Setting it up now, and a low blow right to Akina as he was getting up. Now Adrien, there's from inside the ring, and an elbow right to the throat of Akina. And the advantage going back and forth here. As Adrien now using the ropes for the pin here.
One, two.
Now Akina, the schoolboy of his own. Looking for something here, looking for the pinfall, 2-0. Adrien now back in the attack. Headlock takedown. And following that up with a series of stomps right to the head of Akina. And now Adrien going for the pin.
One, two, and no.
Akina kicks out. Adrien can't get anything going. Adrien now sending Akina back up. Irish whip to the ropes. And a punch sends Akina down. Adrien now, dragging him in the corner, hiding behind the referee. And now, sending the referee into Akina. Akina on the ropes, but not for long. But Adrien runs in, stopping anything Akina had planned. And now Adrien, look at this. Lifting him up, and down, Carnage Breaker. But the referee's still out. Adrien making the cover,
He can't get anything going. Stops as soon as he starts. Akina now. Sending Adrien back down. With the shoulder charges. He's whipping down the ropes. Sends Adrien out. Akina. Right back after him. Going up top of the ladder now. Akina. Looking for something bigger than this. Leg drop from the top of the ladder. And that is what the URWL Hardcore Champion needs to do to keep the belt in his possession. Akina now. He's whipping Adrien into the ring. But Adrien back on the attack. But he sends down the referee instead of Akina. Akina now. Leg whip sends Adrien now. And Akina sends it back up. Big boot. Akina. Our clothesline sends it now. Akina. Picking up Adrien now. And decapitator. Sending his head into the canvas. Akina looking for the pin. But no count. He breaks it up. As he knows the referee wasn't conscious. The referee's now up though. Akina on the attack. Irish whip now sends Adrien outside the ring. Akina now. Looking for another attack. Sends Adrien back in. And a punch right to the head of Adrien on the apron. Akina. Attack. Hard clothesline sends Adrien down. Akina going for the pin once again.
One.
Opportunity here.
Two.
And no, Adrien kicks out. Akina now. Running sidekick. For an Irish whip here. And he sends Adrien bouncing up the turnbuckle. Ladies and gentlemen, Adrien Carnage busting wide open at this point. Akina really taking advantage of this match as he hits a camel clutch suplex. And now Akina sending Adrien out. Comes up right after. Tying up. Using a punch there.
Oh.
Adrien trying to get out himself. Akina now. Once again, the attack. Adrien responds. Akina a third punch. Adrien gets out, and look at that. DDT on the run. Now trying to Irish whip. Akina into that table. He does. Now Adrien sending Akina's head straight into it. Adrien now trying one more time. Trying to set up Akina. He does. Adrien Carnage now. What's going to happen? He's going to the top rope, folks. Adrien Carnage setting something up here. Look at this. No. Spinning elbow drop. Sends Akina through. We'll be right back, folks. Stay tuned.
Sing as their bones come marching.
And ladies and gentlemen, popular demand voting has already started. However, it's only in two categories. So if you have the opportunity, log into the URWL Rampart.
And now, Adrien Carnage reverse DDT through the announce table. The champion just may be done here, folks. The streak just may be over. Adrien Carnage, our reverse DDT through the announce table, and he's not done there, folks. Leg drop using a chair. Adrien Carnage has gone all out in this contest and is making it seem like the champion has nothing left in him. Low blow there by Carnage, sending Akina down. Now, Adrien running in. Elbow to Akina in the corner, sending Akina down. Adrien to the top. Carnage now. Bionic elbow. Hits Akina perfectly. And now, Adrien, once again, gonna try for it. Here comes Carnage Breaker. That's it. Akina just may have lost his first. Never mind. Adrien back on the attack. Akina now. They're gonna break out of the top. He does. And now, Akina with an arm drag. This error in judgment, it seemed, by Adrien Carnage, URWL Tag Team Champion, has backfired. And without West Tamurka to help him out, folks, Akina just may have found the second win he deserves. Now Akina, couple shoulder charges, sending Adrien down. Akina now exhibiting signs of fatigue. He's back on the attack. Irish whip now, right to the corner. Akina, sending Adrien up in the corner. Kicks, third, and a fourth right to the head. Akina's got something going now. He picks Adrien up by the collarbone and sends him straight down. Decapitator. Ladies and gentlemen, the streak continues. Akina gets the win. And the champions for URWL Hardcore take it out of the match after the commercial break, folks. He comes back and delivers an excellent victory. And he plants him into the mat with one of the strongest kicks I've ever seen, the Decapitator. And Akina is still the URWL Hardcore Champion. And now, what the hell is this? That's blood. Obviously bitter over losing his number one contendership. The URWL, the American title, no blood with the ring bell assaulting Akina inside the ring. I never expected this. Blood now. Irish whip to the corner. Sending Akina up. No, it can't be. No, that's the paralyzer DDT. Blood just coming out of nowhere, out of the fans, to assault Akina. And a big boot to ringside. What is the meaning of this? Blood sending a message to the URWL Hardcore Champion Akina. What could this possibly mean? I have no idea. It's insanity is what it is. Ladies and gentlemen, our main event follows this brief promotional message. Stay tuned.
This is an advertisement. This is a very bad advertisement. This could be your advertisement. Stop by the URWL rant board in the commercial request thread, and this will be your advertisement.
Ladies and gentlemen, no one thought Barry White was going to come back. And you are to be well in 2008, much less win the URWL Internet title. But he did. And as a result, he was back on the full-time roster. Let's go to Eddie Mace to introduce our main event of the evening.
Barry!
first in a long line of surprises at Digital Mayhem. By winning the match, Barry White proved to everyone that he is indeed back in URWL and is in good shape after his unfortunate injury at Asphyxiation 2007 at the hands of Interrogative. Ladies and gentlemen, right now, Barry White needs to prove in this match tonight that he is indeed 100%. And if that means standing up to Interrogative one more time, that's what it's going to have to take. URWL champion, Jaime Emo, hits the stage.
And his tag team partner, the Nightmare of Arizona, weighing at 230 pounds, he is URWL champion, Jaime Emo.
Jaime Emo has finally done it. He has achieved the dream that he has chased his entire wrestling career. He has won the URWL Championship. At Digital Mayhem, he collided with Interrogative in one of the more brutal main events in the URWL's history. However, after being battered, beaten, and bloody, Jaime Emo came back and threw Interrogative off the cell to win his first ever URWL Championship. What a moment it was for Jaime Emo. Because Seth Stern decided to return at Digital Mayhem, Jaime Emo has now been forced into another predicament. He is the URWL Champion. But as he's found out most of the time in his career, there is little time to celebrate. Here comes the former champion himself, Toronto.
And now their opponents entering the ring first from Harlem, New York, standing 6 feet 8 inches tall and weighing 280 pounds. He is Interrogative.
After being thrown off the cell at Digital Mayhem, Interrogative has lost everything he has maintained since the YouTube era began. Now, URWL is off of YouTube. Interrogative finds that the title he defended by hook and crook is now around the waist of someone else. Listen to the heckling of these fans here. Overrated chances. This is a change, folks. And because of this, Interrogative is finding himself in a much different situation. He now has to start all over again. And with Barry White returning to action, Interrogative just may have his hands full once again. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here comes the man who intends to make Jaime Emo's life a living hell. It's
Sister.
Despite his favorite priest turn at Disco 2007, folks, Seth Stern has never been on the fan's side. If you want to do well based upon this communication with any hint, Seth Stern lives in a world of creative control, of executive privilege, of a blatant disregard for the URWL, its rulebook, and its fans. He doesn't care. At Digital Mayhem, Seth Stern turned out the lights, literally, on Jaime Emo's celebration and executing what may be called the Star of David from around the world. Right in the exact cell that Jaime Emo won his URWL Championship. Folks, these are Seth Stern's true colors. Earlier tonight, Seth Stern basically told URWL and the world that what he did had to be done. Well, Stern has to put his money where his mouth is. And the two competitors starting off in this matchup are Jaime Emo and Interrogative. The match is up. The running in.
running DDT on Interrogative. The current URWL champion and the former URWL champion going at it here in episode 7 of the URWL. This, as you know, is our main event, and we are privileged to bring it to you. As Jimmy Emo now, crossbody in the corner. Emo, now take over. Right to an arm wrench. Emo. He's on the air, yes! He hits a German suplex. And the fans are appreciating that move, that's for sure. Emo. Another drag in the interrogative versus. Into a man. Emo by the knee. Look at this now, what power! Sends Emo straight down. Fans aren't liking that at all. Sending Emo on the top now. And he sends him down. Kind of a powerbomb type move there. Intro now. Almost a camel clutch situation, but no. Grabs Emo's neck, and he sends him straight down the canvas. Now the fans once again letting Interrogative know that they think he's overrated. And what an insult to Interrogative. I want to take over by Interrogative. Emo trying to get out. Interrogative though making it hard for him. An intro now. Powerful short arm clothesline now. What an attack set up here by Interrogative. As he picks up Emo. Jamie reverses. Emo now, look at this. Inverted suplex. And a great move by Jamie. And now here comes Barry White. Barry and Interrogative facing off for the first time since asphyxiation. As Jamie Emo helps out Barry White and gets one more attack on Interrogative. Another chance of Barry starting here in the URWL arena. For camel clutch here, but Interrogative gets out of it. Intro now. Bulldog right to the mat. These two men have not met one-on-one since the URWL Asphyxiation 2007. Barry now, atomic drop. For a schoolboy here, he gets it. Barry now, it's a pin on him, 2-0. It's rocking him now. Back on the attack. Haymaker sends Barry down. No intro, no! Going after the knee, much like he did Shane B. Perkins and most recently to Jamie Emo. Intro now. Turnbuckle. Look at this now! German suplex by Interrogative. Now intro. On the attack. The Barry chance starting once again for the URWL arena. Barry trying to get out. He does. Now Barry. Close line. Pushes Interrogative over. And now he goes for the pin. Barry now. We can do something here. 2-0. Interrogative tosses the internet champion off of the ease. Interrogative now. That's press and a series of punches now. Brutal attack on Barry White. And now intro continues the onslaught. Intro now. Irish whip to his corner. And now for the first time since Discontent, Seth Stern is back in action. Going after Barry in the corner. More stops. He went to a throw. Berman, Irish whip. Something here. And a takedown by Stern. Stern up over. Pin. 2. And no, Barry kicks out. And a running back elbow now by Stern. Fast-paced, intense style of Seth Stern has really carried him far in his URWL career. And a low blow now to Barry White. Stern now. Arm drag takedown. Seth. Barry back up. Irish whip down to his corner. Stern out, look at that! Runs straight up Barry White acrobatically. Sets him up and down with a super kick. And now Seth, looking for his next move. Tangle with Barry now. Stern. Barry up and sends him down with a vertical suplex. Stern now. Looking Barry up. Looking for an attack here. Arm drag takedown. And the Barry White chance start again here in the URWL arena. They appreciate his accomplishments. Barry White fighting back, responding to the chance himself, and he takes Stern down. Barry now, Irish whip coming to the ropes, and a back toss on Seth. There's no denying that Barry White brings these fans back to an era. era of nostalgia. And now, Fury urges him through the corner, and it tags in Evo. Jamie Evo's in. And now Evo. Neckbreaker unstirred. And now these two men get to meet face to face once again. Evo now. Ballistic toward the arena, and that Jamie chance starting once again. Evo now to the top. Look at this double axe handle. Great move by Evo. Now Evo back in the attack. The stern stops some. Now face crusher quiets the crowd and sends Emo's head straight into the mat. Stern now. Evo back up. Clothesline. Another clothesline. And Stern now. It's coming again. Hebrew hammer punch combination. He now takes some time. Seems to brush the dirt out of his throat. Stern. Back up. He's doing it again. Another Hebrew hammer punch combination. And as you remember back at Association, the multiple moves really was a way to humiliate him in front of all the URWL fans. So Seth is back to his own tricks. Stern picking Emo back up. Emo now, looking for a tag of his own. Emo! Great back suplex! And the fans clapping. It was executed perfectly. Now Emo! And Zugiri sends Stern down. Interrogative looking for the tag. Nothing doing. Stern now reversing. He sent Emo to the corner. And he tags him in traffic. And the former URWL champion sends Evo down, powerbomb from the corner. Intro now back on the attack. Time coming. Evo with a wriggle free. But Intro. Look at this. Intro now holding him up and sending him down. Throwing him across the ring. And now the fans turn to chant, "Let's go, Evo," here in the URWL arena. They want him to succeed in this matchup. They want him to get the victory. As interrogative, bow and arrow. Stern Fury coming back into the ring. And Emo breaks free. Emo not coming in. Close line of the former champion. And now he tags the URWL Internet Champion Barry White. As Barry on the run sends interrogative down by the neck. Barry now back on the attack against the man who put him out. For nearly a year. Camel clutched at my White. Intro now. Looking to break free. He does. Interrogative. Posting to Barry up. Setting him down. Wrestling takedown. Now Intro. Bow and arrow of his own. White trying to break free. Interrogative trying to apply pressure. But Barry moves right out of it. And sends Interrogative down with a shoulder charge. Now Barry a chop, setting Interrogative down. Barry White now. Boston Crab, trying to slow down the match. But Interrogative, spin out he does. Jamie Emo finally getting back on the apron. Interrogative now. Barry's from the corner. And now. Series of punches right to the midsection and finishes it off with a punch in the head. Echoing the amateur boxing style that he has had all these years. Belly to belly suplex. Something he learned from his mentor Salvatore. And now, the former URWL champion signaling for the end. Intro now. It just could be the end here. Aftershock lays Barry out. Interrogative, tagging in the unruly Seth Stern. Intro, back to the bow and arrow lock. Stern now, bring to the corner, sending Emo off the apron. Making sure Emo doesn't break up the hole. Another chance on Barry, starting up once again here. He has always been a fan favorite. Seth Stern almost looking to break the hold up, I guess, but Barry ends up getting out.
Set Barry up once again. Into his own corner. Now Seth, look at this! Poke to the eye. But Barry now! Taking Stern down by the hair! Exploiting that large weakness Stern must have. Excuse the pun. Now Barry. Camel clutch to Stern. Submission attempt once again. But Stern gets right out of it. Now Seth. Back on the attack. Looking to stretch Barry's legs, and he does. Seth now. Sending Barry back up. They tie up. Stern now. First backbreaker. Now Stern. About takeover. Barry trying to get out. And he finally does. Barry now. Irish whip to the corner. Then Stern against the turnbuckle. Finally down. Barry now. Irish whip. Straight almost into Jaime Emo. He sits him down by the hair once again. There's the crescendo. It's Barry. Brings in Emo once again. Now here comes Jamie's opportunity against Stern once again. Jaime now. Called off in the corner. Now. Something here. That's Ubiri on Stern. And Emo now. Once again looking to slow the match down. Boston Crab in the middle of the ring. But it's Rogative. Coming right in. And elbow drop. Looking to break it up. Can't do it. Stern finally spins out. Stern and Emo have a history, folks. As I said that, Stern makes a tag to Interrogative. Intro now. Running Bulldog, taking advantage of the stun, Jaime Emo. Intro now, in the corner. They're gonna set Emo up, and sends him down with a powerbomb. Right from the top rope. Could be looking bad for Emo now. Tie up coming. Intro. Send Jaime away with a punch. Emo with an knee in the midsection. Intro, third punch now. And Emo, breaks the tie up. And Emo sends his rocket down with a clothesline. Now, here comes Barry White. A freshman in. Going to take out Interrogative here. Bob Chop Supreme. Can't hit it all the way, but he finally does. Gets him outside the ring.
One.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, count is starting. Barry now. Hoisting Interrogative over his head. And down on the barrier. Count is at two. Barry now.
Three.
And that daze maybe setting Emo down on accident. As Seth Stern Irish whips him into the ring. Interrogative now. Third attack. Gets Barry up by the knee. Sends him straight down the canvas. Interrogative now. Third attack. Low plus position. Once again, we see this already. Intro. Sends Barry down by the neck. Now it's looking bad. For the internet champion. But Barry, not giving up. Looking to break free. He does. Barry stunned. And Interrogative runs in with a clothesline. Intro once again. Headlock takeover. Barry once again. Looking to break free of it. He does. Barry running in. Another takedown by the head. Barry now. Corner. And he sends Interrogative right in the post. Barry with the slap. Sending Intro down. Now Barry. Sending Interrogative up once again. Barry's into the corner. And now, series of attacks by Barry in the corner. Barry now. Sending Intro up. And down with a powerbomb from the corner. Now what's going to happen for Barry now? Closer by Barry. Chop. And look at this. No clutch. He's got Intro in, but Intro gets out. Oh my God, what a clothesline. Barry White is out. Interrogative.
Two. Three.
Gets the pinfall. And Barry White has been eliminated. Now Jaime Emo running in.
Evo looks to even score. Evo now. Giving up intro. Hardest one for the quarter. Evo now saves it for God. Referee from the top. Evo! He's got intro! Look at this! That's what he calls the emotional finish, folks. Evo now going in for the pin.
Two, three!
Ladies and gentlemen, the crowd is erupted! And Jaime Evo and Seth Stern all alone in the ring. Arm drag now by Stern. But Evo looking for an attack, misses. Running it again now, Jaime Evo. Schoolboy!
One, two, and no!
Stern now, reeling. But Emo, he'll all take over. Do an arm wrench. Push Stern away. And a German suplex. And a chance of Jaime have started once again. Let's take a listen. It's still in close quarters here. Stern breaks away, flips over Emo's back, and sends him down with a spinning elbow. Stern now. Sends Emo to the corner once again. Once again, Stern! Neckbreaker from the top. And now, Stern could be in a good place here. Stern now. No, it can't be! Star David! That's it, ladies and gentlemen. Seth Stern has won the match for his team. Seth Stern and Interrogative are your winners tonight, ladies and gentlemen. And ladies and gentlemen, this is not what Jaime Evo and Barry White had in mind. Seth Stern once again proving that despite all he says, he is still a consummate professional, that he is still a force to be reckoned with here in the URWL. And as Pop Third Man inches even nearer, these four men may just have a lot more to think about. We'll see you in episode 8. Take care.